I'm extremely overwhelmed, you know. I got associated with these projects because of the story, because of how impactful and powerful these stories were. And I'm just glad that my conviction in these films have translated into something really big and outstanding, and I really want to thank everybody for giving it so much love. I'm really flying high right now. Yes, I did, and it was actually pretty funny and ironical, but I'm glad that now people are posting things like this so because they know that, you know, it's wrong. And she's anyways Mrs. Funny Bones. She's hilarious. I follow on Twitter. She's just too good.
I think it's not easy to play this role, and you have to be really secure as a man to do a character who's suffering from erectile dysfunction. But that's the message of the film, that you have to come out in the open and should not brush this subject under the carpet. And I think after watching this film, a lot of men will come forward and discuss it out in open. And if women can discuss about about infertility, why can't men talk about erectile dysfunction? So I think it's high time, and this is the need of the hour. Yeah, that's the message in our film, that manliness is not about getting it up. It's not about about a sexual prowess in bed. It's about different factors, like how chivalrous you are and what kind of stand you take for your family, for your loved ones, in your career sphere. How dignified are you? So I think how strong is your character? I think that's what really matters. Of course, this is one facet of a man, but and it can be solved. The thing is, you need to be open about it and come out with the issue.
Well, the preparation is that firstly I had to unlearn a lot, because none of them are urban girls. So I had to really detach myself from being Bhumi, which is quite a task. But I worked a lot on their lingo. I worked really hard not to play my characters differently, considering they are from the same strata, same belt. So that was definitely tough. But I hope that whenever people see my third film, they sort of see my hard work in all my characters.
I think it's the simplicity and the earnestness and probably honesty, which is similar, which is the only probably congruent area between me and my character in Shubh Mangal Savdhaan. And Mudit Sharma is a nice guy. He's a typical nice guy from North. And apart from that, you know, I don't know anybody who's suffering from erectile dysfunction. As I said, men do not come out in the open about it. Like, even in my peer group, nobody has ever spoken about it. And that's the kind of taboo we need to break with this film. And I'm guessing, after seeing Mudit's problem in the film, how Mudit is being held by his partner Sugandha, how to overcome this problem, people will come out in the open. And that's what the message is in the film.
Absolutely. I think the only common thing between all my characters and me is the kind of strength these girls have. You know, Sugandha is probably the youngest of them all. You know, she's come from a very shielded family, very guarded. You know, she hasn't really ever seen any bitterness in her life. She's only seen love and respect around her, and you know, she will go to any extent to achieve her love, but she will not be a doormat. She will not take crap from her partner. She will not be insulted. She will not be disrespected. And that's a trait that all my characters have, and that's a very big thing that I identify with.
I think the promotions is the toughest part of the entire thing. And of course, when you're shooting and you're filming, that's the most interesting part, because you're giving your heart and soul in your character and making him more as real, as relatable as possible, so that it can resonate with the people who are watching it. And there has to be a certain connect with the masses or the audience. The most difficult is, of course, as I said, promotions. But at the same time, I think promotions are very important, the fundamental part, because you need this movie, should reach out to people. But it's just hectic. We are not following just a 12-hour schedule. We probably go beyond that, because traveling to different cities is physically very challenging. But having said that, it's important.
actually I have one in every film of mine. So in Dam Laga Ke Haisha, the scene where she hears Prem, where Sandhya hears Prem discuss her with all his friends, and he's saying some really brutal things. That scene really, and then he slaps her and she slaps him back. That scene was a very emotional scene for me. In Toilet, the scene where I actually go defecate in the open, my character goes and defecates in the open. That's actually the toughest scene I've ever done in my life. I just couldn't get myself to lift my sari up and squat there in front of so many people. It was very humiliating and I felt extremely violated. In Shubh Mangal Savdhaan, my most favorite scene is a scene between Sugandha and Mudit that happens. I can't tell you a lot about the scene, but it's extremely moving, and it happens like it's one of the most real scenes between them, where she's trying different things to actually, I can't talk about that scene, maybe after the film releases. I think the chemistry was always very good because we are extremely sincere actors, and if you're just playing your character with honesty, there automatically has got to be chemistry. But I think in our personal lives, we've become really good friends, and we now have a lot of fun on set also. So I think that's the only thing that sort of has developed.
I think we don't make films to do pranks because it's a serious business. आप pranks करते हैं पता नहीं होकर वैसे मैं prankster नहीं हूँ
और मैं भी नहीं हूँ
मतलब इसमें हम वैसे ही मजे करते हैं मस्ती करते हैं set पर
मजे
pranks बिल्कुल नहीं किए हैं और of course हम comedy भी seriously करते हैं अगर करते हैं तो बहुत ही serious business है and most of the comedy in the film is like serious as in situation
we are doing it seriously
yeah it's situational comedy it's not that we are making trying to make you laugh Gana is composed by Tanishq and Vayu. They're brilliant in their own thing. Vayu is a great lyricist and he's very quirky with his words. And combination is very lethal because they've come together. They normally come together for Anandel Rai's most of the projects. And Kana is a semi-classical song sung by Sasha Tirupati and she's done a brilliant job with it.
Brilliant job.
And the visuals are so amazing. I think in India we consume music visually. And the chemistry between both of us is absolutely bang on.
It's very sweet yeah. and very simple, very clean. It's like a feeling of first love, you know, gudgudi, butterflies, goosebumps.
Uchi uchi doriyo pe bandh le nagar par na maane na kana maane na jag jo bichhaye har maal chaat le makhan churaye har maal chaat le murli se bole aise trick टिक 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 पनघट की है बड़ी पनघट की है बड़ी कठिन डगर पर ना माने ना काना माने ना नहीं हम उस पता नहीं यार
इतना बड़ा चैलेंज नहीं ले सकता आयुष्मान I think singing, you really have to be God-gifted. एक बहुत ही God-gifted talent है जो सब नहीं कर सकते और जो नहीं कर सकते उन्हें attempt भी नहीं करना चाहिए. रॉकेट सैया एक हमारी फिल्म का एक बहुत ही क्वर्की गाना है एक फन फिल गाना है वो बेसिकली एक मेटाफर है जो रॉकेट तो है ही हमारे सैया लेकिन वो रॉकेट उड़ नहीं पा रहा है फिल्म में उसी के ऊपर ये गाना बना है जो एक्चुअली हमारी फिल्म की जो इशू है और जो ये कपल व्हाट दे आर गोइंग थ्रू से बहुत अच्छे से सम अप कर लेता है एक ऐसी मेलोडी है जो आपके दिमाग में अटक जाती है ऑलरेडी शादियों में बजने लग गया रॉकेट सैया तो बहुत खुशी होती है सुनकर एंड मज़ेदार सॉन्ग है
आई थिंक रॉकेट सैया जो आप फिल्म में देखेंगे वो मॉन्टाजेस हैं जहाँ पर वो जूझ रहा है अपनी इस प्रॉब्लम से एंड ही इज ट्राइंग डिफरेंट थिंग्स टू गेट रिड ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम तो बहुत ही क्वर्की और इट गोज़ विद द थीम ऑफ द फिल्म रॉकेट सैया
Wow. Well, I'm extremely overwhelmed, you know. I got associated with these projects because of the story, because of how impactful and powerful these stories were. And I'm just glad that my conviction in these films have translated into something really big and outstanding. And I really want to thank everybody for giving it so much love. I'm really flying high right now. Yes, I did, and it was actually pretty funny and ironical, but I'm glad that now people are posting things like this so because they know that, you know, it's wrong. And she's anyways Mrs. Funny Bones. She's hilarious. I follow on Twitter. She's just too good.
I think it's not easy to play this role, and you have to be really secure as a man to do a character who's suffering from erectile dysfunction. But that's the message of the film, that you have to come out in the open and should not brush this subject under the carpet. And I think after watching this film, a lot of men will come forward and discuss it out in open. And if women can discuss about about infertility, why can't men talk about erectile dysfunction? So I think it's high time, and this is the need of the hour. Yeah, that's the message in our film, that manliness is not about getting it up. It's not about about a sexual prowess in bed. It's about different factors, like how chivalrous you are and what kind of stand you take for your family, for your loved ones, in your career sphere. How dignified are you? So I think how strong is your character? I think that's what really matters. Of course, this is one facet of a man, but and it can be solved. The thing is, you need to be open about it and come out with the issue.
Well, the preparation is that firstly I had to unlearn a lot, because none of these characters are, none of them are urban girls. So I had to really detach myself from being Bhumi, which is quite a task. I worked a lot on their lingo. I worked really hard not to to sort of play my characters differently, considering they are from the same strata, same belt. So that was definitely tough. I hope that whenever people sort of...
Film Shubh Mangal Savdhaan is releasing on 1st of September. It's quirky, it's funny, it deals with a taboo subject of erectile dysfunction, and it'll be presented in a very entertaining way. Go and watch out.
Well, हमारी फिल्म रिलीज हो रही है 1 सितंबर को शुभ मंगल सावधान, जिसमें आयुष्मान और मैं आपको फिर दिखेंगे एक साथ. ये एक प्यार भरी कहानी है दो ऐसे लोगों की जो एक दूसरे से बहुत ज़्यादा प्यार करते हैं, और कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें होती हैं जिसकी वजह से आयुष्मान के उर्फ मुदित के बिस्किट गिरने लग जाते हैं, और पूरा का पूरा परिवार इन्वॉल्व हो जाता है और बहुत सारा पागलपन होता है. प्लीज़ जाके देखिए 1 सितंबर को शुभ मंगल सावधान.